you hold them up. Let's make our confession and get ready for the word of God. This is my Bible.
This is my Bible.
Oh, come on, say it like you mean it. This is my Bible.
This is my Bible.
I am. What it says I am.
What it says.
I can do
what it says I can do.
I can have
what it says I can have.
Tonight I will be taught the indestructible, ever-living seed
of the Word of God.
And my life
will be the better
after having heard
the word of faith
with fire.
Faith comes by hearing,
and hearing by
the Word of God.
Amen. I want to talk in a little bit tonight about demonstrative faith. I understand that this is your 10th anniversary service, and I know that you've been celebrating, I think, all month, and you have one more to go, two more to go. But I want to give you a word tonight that I think will help catapult you into the next realm. Not necessarily the next level, the next realm.
Yes.
God spoke and gave us a word this year through Dr. Kim Carmichael, who came to our ministry. Actually, she came as a visitor, and the Lord spoke to her and told her to tell us that this was the season of demonstration. The season of demonstration. And of course, people started shouting and getting very excited because they thought that it meant for God to demonstrate some things to them. But God told me, as I began to study it out, and let me just say this, whenever you get a prophetic word, it ought not to be new news. A prophetic word is a confirmation of something that God has already spoken to you. And so as I was listening to this word, I had a witness on it, but the Lord said, study it out. And when I began to study it out, God began to say to me that the season of demonstration was not so that I could see him demonstrate, but that it was my turn to demonstrate some things to God. And as I would to demonstrate things to him, he would lead me to another level and realm, rather, of manifestation. I hope you heard me. As I operated in demonstration, he would lead me to another realm of manifestation. Okay, y'all still not with me. I'm going to say it again. As I operated in another way of demonstration, he's going to lead me to another realm of manifestation. Now, your pastor is a great preacher, and I know y'all done preached. He done preached y'all happy this morning, and y'all done churched out. I just want to drop a few tidbits in here tonight that I think will take this ministry to another level. Y'all got the excellence thing going on. I mean, it is beautiful in this place, and you're operating at a level of excellence that some churches are not operating in, but yet there is still more. You cannot become at ease in Zion. But how do I get out of this thing? You know, for me, I was frustrated, and I told God, I know I'm not your best preacher, but I'm certainly not your worst. I see people who are living raggedy lives having better than I'm having. I see people who are not walking in holiness, who seem to be prospering. Why is it? And the Lord began to show me that I needed to demonstrate rather than compare myself to somebody else. I don't think you're hearing me.
Yes.
A lot of times you're comparing yourself to someone else, and God says that this is not what I'm calling you to do. I'm calling you to demonstrate his word back to him. Demonstrate his word back to him. So when I confess the word of God, I've got to make sure that I'm not confessing my wants. See, listen, God is never going to give you somebody else's husband. God is not going to give you somebody else's ministry. I went to church this morning, Free Gospel Deliverance Temple, and I had to set the house in order because Bishop Green's son split their church, and you can listen to me, while you are trying to make a blessing, you will miss a blessing. You are not going to make a blessing and get the blessing that was intended for you to have in the first place. God has a blessing that he is waiting to give to you, but he's waiting to see if you can handle it. Can you be found worthy of what he wants to give you? Well, it's evident that you need a new place, and it may not be evident to you because you're saying, well, I don't see all of the people in here now. Well, they were here this morning, or they're here during the week, or whatever, but you need a new place just to do ministry. And some people are saying, well, Bishop, I don't know if we can afford a new place. I don't know if we can do this, because how are we going to do with what we have? And God says to you, you don't go on what you see. You go on what you say. That's why you can have what you say. I moved, Bishop, into a 15. This looks like our first church. Our first church was about this size, maybe a little smaller. Maybe it was smaller. I'm talking about the sanctuary was smaller than this, but a little smaller than this, on top of a moving and storage company. We didn't have a pulpit like this. I still sat in the front, And, you know, we didn't fill it up. But God told me to move, and I moved into a 15,000 square foot building with 50 people. And when we got to the 50 people, about 23 or 27 of them almost walked off because they didn't think we could afford it. The note was $10,000 a month, and that was 3 years ago, and we're still there. And now we have over 300 people to the church, and the church is only 5 years old. We celebrate 6 years old in November. You go on what you see. Good Lord, help me. You go on what you say. And you have what you say. If you say it's a hard day, it's going to be. If you say life is tough, life is going to be. You have what you say. And so when the Lord started talking to me about demonstration, I got this from my pastor. Let me see what I mean. I got this thing of definitions from my pastor. I think it's important that we don't just tell you things, but that we define them for you. So when I say demonstrative faith, the Lord gave me a definition of demonstrative faith. And if you can't get it all down, just get the CD. I'm sure that they're recording because the definition is long. I have longevity. Has its place. But demonstrative faith is a faith that shows the principles of faith acted out in a daily life situations and produces manifestations desired at a maximum level. It is a place and time in faith where I am challenged to show actions beyond my own ability and capacity. This action will catapult me into the next realm of manifestation. A place where most dream to be, I will now reside. I'm living in my dream. My dreams are realities. Are y'all living? I feel the Holy Ghost. I got some work to do, but I feel the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
But see, the reality is that you have to change your emphasis just a little bit and become. Now, see, most people, when you teach faith, Bishop, most people think they have faith, but most people don't have faith. Ask me how I know. Because I didn't have it, and I had been preaching for years. Because faith is more than Hebrews 11:1, that faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. Faith is more than that.
Yeah.
Faith is the creative power of God that's made available to man, whereby man can transform situations and circumstances in the natural realm over which he has been given authority.
Okay.
Faith is believing that the word of God is true, and that what God says in his word is true, and that he's able to bring it to pass. Yes. This confidence, this reliance on God's word, this is faith.
Yes.
Faith is not what church you belong to. Faith is not what denomination you're a part of. Faith is not who you're connected to. Faith is in God.
Yes.
I feel the Holy Ghost. I said faith is in God.
Yes.
And so when God told me to demonstrate faith, he asked me to look at some questions. And the reason that some churches are able to surpass others, and some people in the Church of the Lord's Harvest are able to receive more than others are, and they sit on the same row, is because, not because that they're better than anybody else, but it's because of the level of their faith.
Yes.
Are you listening to me? Because have you ever asked anybody, how is it that I hear the same thing but I get different results? It's just like a person who knows how to cook. They don't need to look at the recipe. But someone who can't cook has to look at the recipe in order for it to come out right.
Yeah.
Are you listening to me?
Yeah.
Well, you may not be able to cook like a person who can't look at the recipe, but you look at the recipe long enough that it will become a habit.
Yeah. Yeah.
Are you listening to me?
Yeah.
So now, Hebrews 11 and 1, let's look at it. But I want to look at it in the Amplified Bible. And we're going to turn in the Bible a lot, and then we're going to get to where you want to go. How about that? Can we make an agreement?
Amen.
Now, the more you say amen, the sooner I sit down. And I'm like Bishop Rosie O'Neill. If I say like this, that means give me some more. Hebrews 11 and 1 in the Amplified says this. Now, faith is the assurance, the confirmation, the title deed.
Yeah.
Faith is the title deed of the things we hope for.
Yes.
Being the proof of the things we do not see and the conviction of their reality. Faith perceiving as real fact what is not revealed to the senses. Faith perceiving as real fact what is not revealed to the senses. I can't see it, I can't touch it, can't taste it, but I know it's there. I thought I was in a Holy Ghost filled church. I said, I can't see it. I can't touch it. I can't taste it. But I know it's there. Have you ever just felt like something was getting ready to happen? You couldn't describe it. You could not put a word to it. You couldn't find a scripture even to. But you knew something was getting ready to happen. Turn to your neighbor and say, something's getting ready to happen. Lord. Turning your Bibles to Matthew 9:27. Matthew 9:27. And have it say amen. Oh, I feel like working. I drank a 5 hour. Glory to God. So that means I should be finished about 1.